Hello, everyone. I'm Michelle Johnson.
And I'm Chris Phillips, otherwise known as Zoe Bowie. And I'll tell you what a terrific show we have for you this month as we commemorate the holidays, Veterans Day, and, of course, Thanksgiving.
Entertainment reporter Diane Davis, that avant-garde gal about town, will review the pop group Human Nature.
And our perennial favorite, Book Talk, has a biography by Sun City Anthem author Donna Mabry titled Maud.
And in honor of Veterans Day, Don Walsh will share some of his personal thoughts.
And of course, there will be clips from Anthem's Got Talent along with other special surprises.
And Chris and I will share highlights from some of our past performances that are sure to make you smile.
So grab your favorite beverage, settle down in that comfy chair, and join us for a trip down memory lane next on
Anthem Alive.
Michelle, it is so nice being here with you, hosting Anthem Alive. You obviously are such a talented singer, songwriter, and producer. Your singing has been described as a cross between Carole King and Ella Fitzgerald, and your words echo traces of gospel and folk. Your music truly has inspired and uplifted us all, and I don't know if you can tell, but I'm kind of a fan.
Thank you, Chris. I'm a fan of yours as well, and I just love you to death. You know that. Wow. And I can say the same about you. You've been getting the party started in Vegas for more than a decade with your high-energy nightclub dance concert, and it speaks to your enduring popularity. Hey, let's take a quick look at you in action.
Oh, no.
That's it.
Obviously, I've been very fortunate and so lucky to kind of live out my dream here in Vegas by making others happy. We'll have a clip of Michelle in action a little later in the show, if that's okay.
Yes, right after we introduce our first segment from our friend Diane Davis. Now, you guys, it's been a few years since Diane did her review of Human Nature. Somewhere during those years, we had this COVID thing, and the guys had to go back to their native land. Oh, you want to know where? Diane, tell our viewers all about them and their fabulous show.
Was it just my imagination, or was I at South Point to once again enjoy the songs, the on-point choreography, the throwback costuming, the phrasing, and the synchronized musical treatments of Human Nature? The Australian boys first got together in 1989 as teenagers. Now they are men, back in Las Vegas and as good as ever in his show titled Back to the Sounds of Motown. Hear the chart-topping songs made famous by the Temptations, the Shirelles, and the Supremes. Add to that other jukebox favorites. It has been too long since COVID exiled these entertainers from their Las Vegas gig to their native Australia, but now they are here to ask the question, will you still love me tomorrow? The audience, which included many of our neighbors from our Sun City Anthem active senior community, would have been dancing in the street if there was room. The garb and the choreography are a throwback to the days when Motown was the way to go. They've got the moves down pat and the outfits to go with them. As the guys will tell you, Smokey Robinson is the man who brought them to America and to Motown. They were a boys band in Australia and have now been together for 34 years. How sweet it is to be loved, and are they ever. Preceded by a reference to the Righteous Brothers, who, by the way, return regularly to South Point to the delight of their many fans, we get to enjoy human nature doing Unchained Melody. I heard it through the grapevine that you can enjoy Stop in the Name of Love and My Girl, as well as I'll Be There, when you are there at the South Point for their show in November. Then, well, hop a plane to Australia and catch their December tour there. Go see Human Nature and enjoy.
Thanks, Diane, for that review. And as we all know, when you speak, people listen. Now, I know that if a show doesn't feel like it lives up to your standards, you won't review it. So, glad to say that you have reviewed my shows along the way.
And mine too, thank goodness.
This would be the best time to show our viewers clips of the incredible Michelle Johnson, the performer.
So easy when I was young. My fingers slipped over keys and told stories of songs that were still unsung. I wrapped my heart in each word from you. You were the light in the tunnel that led to the path I was headed to. But time will make you forget all you're meant to be, living your life by what the outside sees. And I've been gone for so long. So I'm letting you know, I'm letting you see just what's become of the woman you helped me to be. And I'm running my race, my face to the wind, circling back to the place where you helped me begin. But this time, I'm all in. I thought my heart and my soul were gone, as though you left me alone with no rhymes and no reason to carry on. So I got lost in the maddening crowd, and through the chaos around me, my heart was still longing to sing out loud. And all the scenes in my life, they came back to me. all stitched together like a tapestry, and I've been gone for too long. So I'm letting you know, I'm letting you see just what's become of the woman you helped me to be. And I'm running my race, my face to the wind, circling back to the place where you helped me begin. But this time I'm all in. But this time I'm all in.
You know, I love performing for the audience and fans, and it just gives you such a nice, warm feeling
yes.
when you know you've given them a great time.
I live for it.
Yep, I know. I know you do. You know, did you know that Sun City Anthem is the only active adult community in Nevada with its own TV station? Not only does the station provide valuable information and entertainment to its viewers, but it also showcases the many talents of its residents.
The SCA-TV website, which is suncityanthemtv.com, tells about upcoming activities like concerts, shows, trips, seminars. Check out Veterans Corner, Freedom is Not Free, SCA Crime Report, and Homeowners Association updates.
A lot of information about this community can also be found in the Monday Morning Community Chronicles and in the Spirit Magazine. If you subscribe to Cox, SCA-TV programming is on channel 1960, and the schedule is printed in the relay, an insert of the Spirit magazine. Email SCA-TV if you have problems with your Cox TV channel, or call the number on your screen.
You may also want to follow SCA-TV on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Hashtag SunCityAnthemTV. Now subscribe to the SCA-TV YouTube channel as well and check out regularly for updates and uploads.
This community also has an author's club, and today's book talk with Irene Consiglia features the best-selling biography, Maud, by local resident Donna Mabry.
I'm Irene Consiglia, and this is Book Talk. Today's book selection is titled Maud by Donna Foley Mabry. I came into this world as Nola Maud Claiborne in 1893 in Perkinsville, Tennessee, a town pinned to the ground by a church spire, a Baptist church to the east, and a Holiness church to the west. My family was Holiness, and our lives revolved around the church. That is how Maud begins the narration of her life story in this memoir written by her granddaughter, Donna Foley Mabry. It was a time before women had the right to vote, to choose whom to marry, to even get more than an eighth grade education. This was before the conveniences of electricity and indoor plumbing, the motor car and the aeroplane. Women tended the livestock, planted the garden, made their own clothes, and even birthed each other's babies. The lessons they taught were of resilience and perseverance. Little Maud was a daddy's girl, built sturdy like him, not dainty like her older sister. But being plain by comparison didn't bother her much. It was something she had gotten used to. And there were a lot more things she would have to get used to when at age 8, her parents died in a tragic house fire and her sister's baby was stillborn. Suddenly, this 8-year-old was faced with the daunting task of caring for her ailing sister. When she got older, a neighbor boy named Connor would sometimes come over to keep her company on the porch. When he asked her what she wanted out of life, the question took her by surprise because no one had ever concerned themselves with her wants before. Timidly, she spoke of graduating high school and seeing faraway places like the ocean. But Maud's dreams were of little consequence because at age 14, she was given away in marriage to James and would live with him in a one-room cabin on his parents' property. Maud had learned early on to snatch happiness from the most unlikely places and found fulfillment as a young wife and mother. But this happiness too was short-lived when James was killed in a freak accident during a baseball game. Once again, Maud trudged behind the undertaker's wagon to the cemetery to bury someone who had given her love and security. What would become of me and my little girl? I had already been an orphan, a wife, and a mother. Now I was a widow and only 16 years old, she lamented. Then a man named George Foley came to town. As he began to make overtures toward her, Maud didn't quite know what to think. She didn't really even like him much at first, but social pressures forced her to marry him anyway. And when he took her away to his home in Missouri, Maud got not only a stranger as a husband, but a surly mother-in-law as well. The wedding vows she spoke to love, honor, and obey weighed heavily on her. Would she be able to love this man? Gaining strength from her faith, she resolved to find happiness no matter how elusive it might be. Yes, Maud came of age during the 20th century, voting for the first time in a presidential election, enduring the Great Depression, surviving the war years. She bore 4 children to this man in a marriage of convenience. And as she reflected back on her long life, Maud concluded that God gives each of us a measure of happiness, and some are allotted more than others, just like the ration stamps handed out during the war. Maud, by Donna Foley Mabry, has been on the Wall Street Journal's top 10 list, is currently a bestseller on Amazon with 4- and 5-star ratings from 86% of its reviewers, and is available on a number of formats, including a new audio version, which is being translated into numerous foreign languages. Maud is a memorable book, and I too give it 5 stars. The author, Donna Foley Mabry, who resides in Sun City Anthem, is a prolific writer across a number of genres, including the best-selling Alexandra Merritt mystery series. She is also an active member of Anthem Authors, where she shares her expertise as a mentor to other aspiring writers. Until next time, I'm Irene Consiglia.
Thank you, Irene. Donna Mabry's grandmother, Maud, faced the tragedies in her life with such courage and perseverance.
Women have certainly come a long way since the turn of the century.
Veterans Day formerly known as Armistice Day, commemorates the end of World War I. Today is celebrated by acknowledging and thanking the veterans and their families for their incredible service. Did you know that as of September 22, 2021, there were about 1.2 million men and women on active duty and 778,000 in reserve?
And they have certainly earned our gratitude for service to this country. On Veterans Day, we honor all of those who served in the military. And as of May 2022, that includes over 19 million men and women.
Yes, we wish to thank all our past and present veterans for their incredible service. Now, viewers are invited to go to the website suncityanthemtv.com and tap on the icon Freedom is Not Free to view personal stories of 145 Anthem veterans who are our neighbors and friends. And now Don Walsh will share his thoughts on Veterans Day.
Hi, my name is Don Walsh. We're coming up on the 11th of November, which is celebrated as Veterans Day across America. We celebrate because that was the day in 1919 that the fighting ended in the Great War, as World War I was known at the time. The armistice, or truce, began on the 11th day of the 11th month at the 11th hour between the Allies and Germany. The armistice was signed by representatives of the German, French, and British governments at 0500 hours. The armistice itself began 6 hours later at 1100 hours, and that day became known as Armistice Day. That's what my dad, a World War II vet, called it until the day he died. Some countries around the world have officially declared November 11th as Armistice Day, while others call it either Remembrance Day or Veterans Day. Most of the Commonwealth nations, such as the UK and Australia and Canada, refer to it as Remembrance Day, while in France, Belgium, Serbia, and in New Zealand, it is still called Armistice Day. In the United States, November 11th became an official holiday in 1926, a national holiday in 1938, and in 1954, the name of the holiday was officially changed to Veterans Day. Personally, I don't like changes in the names of holidays because it only leads to more confusion of just what the holiday or holidays are meant to observe. I will never get tired of telling people that Memorial Day, which is celebrated on the last Monday in May, honors those who actually died during their military service. If you didn't die while on active duty, Memorial Day is not for you. It is a distinct holiday set aside to honor those who made the ultimate sacrifice while on active duty in the military. Veterans Day, on the other hand, honors all those who have served and are currently serving in our military. If you have an uncle who returned safely from overseas during World War II, or a family member who served in our military or is currently serving, this is their day. At the core, every one of these holidays is intended to remind us to acknowledge and honor the service of our military. The hundreds and thousands of men and women who have served us courageously in time of war and in time of peace. The Veterans of Foreign Wars, or VFW as it is commonly known, was formed in 1899, and the American Legion was formed in 1919. They were formed to support veterans' causes, and they do a wonderful job in every state and in many foreign nations. But we're fortunate to have a veterans club right here in our community, the Sun City Anthem Veterans Club. The SCA Veterans Club is a vibrant and active club. In the years since it was formed, an interesting and symbiotic relationship has formed between the Veterans Club and SCA-TV station. Several members of the SCA Veterans Club were active in the initial formation of the TV station, and others remain active in the day-to-day operations and ongoing productions of SCA-TV. Veterans helped to get the station off the ground, and SCA-TV continues to vigorously support the Veterans Club in all its many endeavors. I'm a longtime member of the American Legion in both New York and in California, and I'm still a member of a post in Southern California. I've not transferred my membership to a post closer to where I now live, in part because I do believe that I have found a veterans club that promotes every aspect of support for veterans that I believe to be important. That club is the Sun City Anthem Veterans Club. You might know of them for the fun and very popular annual ice cream social that they put on each summer. You won't want to miss the special ceremony put on by the members of the Veterans Club. The ceremony starts at 1100 hours in the Delaware Room. There will be 350 plus people in attendance, so please don't be late. We truly want to celebrate the day together with all of you. We want to honor the service of the men and women currently serving in our military, and also celebrate the service of the veterans across America who have served before them. I hope to see you there. This is Don Walsh for SCA-TV.
Thank you, Don, for that educational and informative report.
You know, I look forward to Thanksgiving every year because it's the holiday that we celebrate together as a nation. And yes, food plays a role, but more important is the rekindling of family bonds and the joy that comes from breaking bread together. Oh, by the way, Chris, who is not hungry at Thanksgiving?
Who is not hungry at Thanksgiving? I don't know.
The turkey, because he's already stuffed.
All right. That's terrible.
I know.
All right, I have one for you.
That was really bad. Okay.
What kind of weather does a turkey like?
What kind of weather does a turkey like? I don't know.
Foul weather.
Oh. So bad.
Turkey jokes.
It's so bad that it's good.
Can't be the turkey joke.
But seriously, Chris, what are some things that you feel thankful for at Thanksgiving?
Oh, gosh. You know, as we were talking about, I guess first and foremost, I think it would be appropriate to say that I'm thankful for so many incredible, brave men and women who are willing to sacrifice their lives to, quite honestly, keep the American way and our freedoms intact. That is something I think we all need to appreciate a little more often, in my opinion. But personally speaking, I am so incredibly thankful, just to be honest. Things have changed in my life recently, and I want to thank my wife, Jennifer, who I adore, for bringing something into my life I never thought was going to happen, and that is my gorgeous little five-year-old daughter, Ava, who has just changed my entire reality and purpose for living and purpose for even doing what I do now. It takes on a whole different meaning, and so I'm thankful for that little that little crazy. That
makes sense.
Certainly has brought a different perspective to my existence. But what about you, Michelle?
Well, I'm thankful for my family, and my mom moved here about a year ago, a year and a half ago, and I'm really thankful that I get to spend so much time with her. She just turned 90 in July. She's super active and healthy, and I'm just grateful that I've learned to appreciate not to take anything for granted, and that I have time with her right now.
Did she
and it's
you
precious.
To sing at all,
she did. She introduced me to theater and music, and I'm grateful for that too. She basically started me off thinking it would be a hobby, and lo and behold, it became something else. But yeah, I'm grateful for that too.
Well, thank goodness for her on many levels. Then.
Yeah, my mom's great. My mom's great.
Aww.
I know that the residents in Anthem are thankful for all the opportunities they have to stay active and healthy. And there are so many talented people here who, when given the chance, are eager to strut their stuff. Here's a clip from Anthem's Got Talent 2022.
Please put your hands together for our very own celebrity host, Mark O'Toole.
That's better. Hi, everybody. They asked me to do this, and I got the seventh Anthem's Got Talent, and I said, I'll do anything for Anthem. And here I am for you guys, and we're going to have such a great time today. This is back from the 1930s, performing the updated version, first seen on the Johnny Carson Show back in the 1980s. So hold on to your hats, folks, and give them a nice big Anthem welcome to the Who's On First and our first showman for the time. Let's do it.
Well, all right, Ms. Harrell, you can send in Chief of Staff Jim Baker.
Yes, Mr. President.
Morning, Mr. President.
Well, good morning, Jim. Just have a seat there.
Oh, sure. Now, Mr. President, the press conference, your press conference, is scheduled to begin in an hour, so we only have a short time for me to brief you on some of the kinds of subjects that the press may throw at you.
Well, now, the environment's on everybody's mind, so, I'm sure they'll ask me about my Secretary of Interior.
What?
I said I'm sure they'll ask me about my Secretary of Interior.
What?
Jim, I just said I'm sure they'll ask me about my Secretary of Interior.
James Watt. You're scheduled to go swimming with him tomorrow morning at the Y.
Where?
Why?
Why?
That's right. With what?
I love you so, always will. When I look at you, I see the passion eyes of May. Oh, but am I ever gonna see my wedding day?
And I realized that in 1987, the United States, the United Kingdom, China, and Russia and Mike Maloney were nuclear powers. Thank you.
Mike Maloney.
And all of my strength that I give to you. And I love completely. You lose and you leave me.
Oh, Suki Tawdry, shout out to Lada Lania, and don't forget Lucy Brown. Something. I wanna hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand.
And then one day, a magic day, he passed my way. And while we spoke of many things, fools and kings, this he said to me, the greatest thing you'll ever learn is just to love and be.
Like cottage cheese on my thighs.
Now, I love living in a 55-plus community. It's a lot like being in middle school, though, because, you know, you have the jocks at the gym, and you have the tattletales on the Nextdoor app. Somebody went over the speed limit. And who would have known there's such thing as 70-year-old mean girls? One of them says to me, I've been married to the same man for 47 years. I'm like, bitch, I found three men to marry me. You may have your original husband, but I have my original face.
Bring him peace. Bring him joy. He's young. He is only a boy. You can take, you can give, let him be, let him live. If I die, let me
I'm gonna lose my mind. If she ever comes back to stay, it's gonna be another brand new day. I'm walking with my baby down the side of Samson's doorway.
Torment won't be through till you let me spend my life making love to you day and night, night and day.
Yeah.
Rich girl got married in a fine silk dress. Poor girl, she didn't have a train. My girl, she didn't even say I do, but she does just the same. Oh, lay, yeah, 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 yeah.
Chef, everybody.
Sold out performance, and having Mark O'Toole hosting was very much appreciated by everyone, of course. And we have other shows or events coming up that the community is very excited about. Let's hear about them. Yeah.
Happy holidays. Well, almost. Hello, I'm Phil Mistrelli, and I sing bass.
And my name is Sharon Howe, and I sing soprano.
And it really does seem like the holidays to us. After all, our longtime music director, Dick Field, has had the chorus singing carols since last August.
Our entire chorus is so excited about our new show. It's called A Holiday Portrait in Music.
And whether you celebrate Christmas, Hanukkah, Las Posadas, Kwanzaa, Ramadan, or all of these,
please join us at Freedom Hall Theater. Our first show is being performed on Friday evening, December 9th at 7 o'clock p.m.
and a matinee on Saturday, December 10th at 2 p.m. You can get your tickets now for only $10 at the website on the screen or the activities office.
Come along! It's Christmas!
Okay, so Chris, I am so excited about this. Many of you attended the Anthem's Got Talent event,
yes.
And there was a raffle, right?
Yes.
We have the honor of picking the raffle winners today.
Oh, these
and
look
there
incredible.
Are three amazing prizes.
I'm jealous.
We'll show them to you in a second. And here, let me show you one. We're going to raffle off this beautiful basket first.
Some wonderful books. Oh, gosh, this would be a fun thing to have for the holidays.
So these are from Marianne Unger. Aren't they gorgeous? There's three of them. And we're going to raffle off this first one. It looks like some incredible books and all kinds of gorgeous stuff inside.
It'd be great for kids because
yeah.
I see it's kind of a children's theme in here.
Yeah, kind of. So this says children's book, Anthem authors. Oh, my goodness. So this is authors from
for
the community,
sakes.
Which is wow. So impressive. So let's raffle off this one first.
All righty.
Okay, you ready? So you can... All right, and the winner of this basket is Diane Bold. Congratulations,
oh,
Diane. You've just won a wonderful basket from the raffle.
Congratulations.
You want to do another one?
I would love to, and
okay.
I wish I had gone to the Anthem's Got Talent
Me
just
too.
So I could join this raffle,
Me
but
too.
If you don't mind, I'd like to try to see if we can't find somebody here mm-hmm. that's going to be very excited to have one of these. And
All
this
right.
would be, which one should we pick out?
Let's pick this.
Oh,
this is that, beautiful.
Oh, I like that. It's all
this
about mysteries.
This one says mysteries. Also Anthem authors. Isn't this gorgeous?
Well, I, you know, I'm particularly fond of the fact that there's booze in it.
I was just going to say, the wine is
so we have some wine
calling
and,
us. And
some mysteries.
Beautiful books and some beautiful red glasses.
Well,
okay, who's getting this one?
This is going to be, oh my gosh. I think we know her.
Okay.
Karen Gibson.
Karen, wonderful.
Karen, congratulations.
Good for you, Karen.
We'll be joining you that night, and I'll bring the glasses.
Congratulations, Karen. All right, we got one more.
Alrighty.
One more. I'll do this one, but I want to see the basket first.
Okay.
What's it say?
Let's see here.
Oh, this is my favorite kind of book. These are memoirs, okay? Memoirs written by Anthem authors. I don't know... Miss Unger did a fabulous job of putting these together.
Gorgeous.
They're gorgeous.
Wonderful.
Okay, so this is memoirs, and let me pick the winner. This is going to be Diana Chang. Congratulations, Diana. You've won the wonderful basket. Yay. Cool.
Well, I'll tell you, just remember your friends, Michelle and Zoe Bowie. We would love to have you have us over as well. So, you know, before we leave, though, I got to say a special thanks to our dear friend, Diane Davis.
We love you, Diane.
And her husband, Bert.
Yes.
And, you know, I've known you for many years, and a lot of people don't know this, but she was the first singer for Zoe Bowie back in the early 70s.
There you have it. Never a dull moment in this community. Are you having fun hosting Anthem Alive, Chris?
Yes, I'm personally thinking that we should maybe do this every month now, if we could possibly do that. This is...
You've been getting the party started for more than a decade as Zoe Bowie. How'd you come up with the name?
Oh, gosh. You know, I thought to myself, who'd want to pay to see Chris Phillips?
Well, that's honest.
No, it's a silly story. Actually, this year I'm coming up on my 30th anniversary of calling myself that silly name.
Oh my
just because
gosh.
I can hide behind it as a character. Quite frankly, I thought in case I bombed on stage, I could pretend, hey, I'm David Bowie's kid, Zoe Bowie. But that never had any relevance to the
So it was identity theft.
It was identity theft, so I could hide behind it like a little scared child. And, you know,
yeah.
No, and it's worked for 30 years, and I hope I never have to grow up.
It's a great name for you. And you were voted the number one dance and show band in Vegas. You're named Best Lounge Act in Vegas. And you were even named Best in Vegas. That is an honor. But what are you most proud of, Chris?
The fact that I'm sitting here with Michelle Johnson hosting Anthem Live TV. Are you kidding me? This is it. Where do you go from here?
Oh, you're crazy.
No, I you know, quite frankly, just to be very honest, I got into this. Long story short, I'll try to make very brief.
Okay.
But the reason I'm bringing this up is it kind of came full circle last night.
Hmm.
I came to Vegas in the late 70s. I went to the Hilton Hotel, sat down in the showroom. This incredible performer came out. Tan, teeth, hair, in this orchestra, and I was blown away by his charisma and how he absolutely captured the audience. And
okay.
I was a kid, and I was so enamored by the beauty and the pizzazz Vegas had to offer.
Yeah.
I'll be darned, halfway through the show, he comes out to the audience, comes right to my booth, leans down, and the light spotlight's on us, he's dripping sweat, and he goes, "Welcome to Las Vegas, young man." And the energy and the impact that made on me made me know that for the rest of my life I was going to strive to come to Las Vegas.
Wow.
Simply so I could make people feel as incredible as he made me feel that night. It was the most magical power. So it was never for me about singing or anything. It was about wanting to make people feel good.
Okay.
Put smiles on their faces. Long story short, that was 42 years ago.
Okay.
Last night I went to a show. This same performer got up on stage, sang some songs. And as a full circle came to
Again.
Complete with me, Tony Orlando called out my name on stage and said, "There was a kid with a dream 42 years ago. He's here tonight. Zoe Bowie
oh
is here."
Oh, my gosh.
And I apparently had something to do with him being here. And now I'm saying to him, "I'm a fan of yours. And wow. thank goodness you made your dreams come true. And I hope it does for a lot of other people." And so 42 years in the making, I got to see that same guy that I worship so much. That made me want to be a Vegas entertainer, stand on stage and say my name, and I was just like,
"Oh my gosh!
Okay, that's it.
That's it. There's nothing left."
So for me, it's just about trying to make people happy and put smiles on their faces and create the true, I think, spirit of what Vegas is mm-hmm. supposed to be all
mm-hmm.
about.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm very honored as you
story.
Are to call yourself a Vegas entertainer.
Yes,
for sure.
I am. I'm totally love living
now,
here.
Now, that's a cute little story, but that doesn't compare to how interesting your story. If you know, I got to tell them now. I know that you grew up in Cairo, Egypt.
Mm-hmm.
You graduated from Yale.
I did.
En route to Harvard Law.
Yes.
How did you wind up in music instead? I don't understand. My gosh.
Well, you know, I always wanted to do music and theater as a child. I fell in love with it. But my parents wanted me to have something to, as they say, fall back on. And I got into
so
Yale.
Jealous.
And I got into a lot of really good schools like that, and picked Yale because it was the closest to New York, which meant I could sneak away and go see Broadway shows and other things like that. So that's really how I ended up picking it. But I loved it. I loved my time
Amazing.
There. And while I was there, I actually made a lot of friends in music and theater, and so that just kept going. And after I got out, I went straight into not law, but music. It was what my heart called me to do. So much to my parents' chagrin sometimes.
Yes.
No, they're happy about it now, but it took a minute. But that's how I ended up in the business.
I can tell
just
you,
kept
we
going.
Are very fortunate that you
oh,
made that
you.
Fork in the road instead. And God bless you for doing it.
Because, thank you.
You're not just a talent. You have this magical presence to your
thank you, Chris.
Performance that just makes everybody feel so good. And if you have not seen Michelle before, mm-hmm. trust me, you need to go see one of her shows. And, wow, what a journey. Congratulations, by the way, and your title is Las Vegas First Lady of Jazz. And you are also the recipient of the National Association of Women Business Owners Woman of Distinction Award, as well as the Lena Horne Award for Musical Excellence. So, let me ask you the same question. What are you most proud of?
I think what I'm most proud of is staying grounded and staying focused on keeping my relationship with my fans first and foremost in my career. Because it's easy to get a big head. It's easy to keep going for the next thing or wanting to sing with this celebrity or that celebrity. And I've gotten to do that, but it doesn't compare to what happens when I just run into someone who's seen a show and they tell me some way that it impacted them.
Yes,
I mean, that
yes.
is a big deal.
It is, I know.
And people minimize it. They think, oh, I don't want to bother you or I don't want to say anything to you. But when I find out that I made someone cry or laugh or I made someone stay or made them feel better, that is what I'm the most proud of. Because at the end of the day, we're all the same. And that's the thing that joins us is emotion, hopes, dreams, fears, and love. And that's why I do what I do.
Well, bless your heart for doing that. And I can kind of relate in the sense that I don't know how many times, actually, I'm not sure if I've been more responsible for bringing people together in marriage or separating them in divorce. And if
What's
that's not enough, no, I got to back to you. You also were part of contributing to writing a book. It was called Platform of Power.
Or actually, it's called The Power of the Platform. And it's a book, it's kind of a self-help book written by various thought leaders that encourage people to be their best selves. It's like an advice book, inspirational book. And that's the kind of projects that I'm working on now outside of music is writing books about how to be your best self and how to be powerful, but I'm taking it from a musical angle, so.
See, that's very impressive to somebody who probably can't even spell powerful.
Yes, you can. He's smarter than he looks, or than he says he is anyway. It's true. Okay. And I try to bring that power into every show that I do. I'm coming up on a Christmas show, which is one of my favorite times to really connect with people. Holiday shows, I love the holidays, I love that music. And I'm going to be at the Smith Center on Sunday, December 18th at 7 p.m. I love playing there. It's one of my favorite places to play.
It says a lot about you because only the best of the best perform there.
Well, thank you. I love the room, and I love that it's a small, intimate room. It's going to be at 7 p.m. on a Sunday. That's the 18th. And the tickets are on sale now at the Smith Center website. So anybody who wants to come and enjoy some holiday jazz,
I highly advise seeing this
young lady. It's called A Jazzy Christmas, and it's going to be great. All the classics.
Well, wonderful.
That's what I'm doing. Oh, and by the way, Chris, I have a wonderful Christmas album.
Yes.
It's a jazzy take on Christmas songs, and it is out now. You can get it at my website. And if you come to my show, I will sign a copy of the album. So I hope I see you there, but even if you don't come, pick up this record. I'm very proud of it. So Chris, where can people see you next?
Well, I've been very fortunate that I've been performing pretty much weekly for about 28 years. I don't know if that's something I should be proud of or gross.
You should be proud because you're still standing.
But we do weekly shows out on the Fremont Street Experience. We're also at the M Resort every month or two. But the thing I'm excited to share with you folks is, as with you, I love the holidays.
Yes.
And so my wife, who designs all our showgirl costumes, says, you've got to do a Christmas show so we can show off the costumes and revel in the holidays. And so we have a Zoe Bowie Christmas and Cocktails in Vegas show coming up at the Italian American Club on Sunday. That's November 27th. It's going to be with my big band, of course, and female guest artists, including Jamie Lynch, who is the singer in my show. And we're going to be highlighting the fabulous ZB Showgirls. So we'd love to have you join us for a wonderful dinner and revel in the party to kick off the holiday spirit.
And it sounds so swanky in old Vegas.
Oh,
I love that.
See, that's why I came to Vegas, is I love the classic era of this town. I want to thank you for giving me validation by being in my show over the years and vice versa.
I love it.
I couldn't tell you how much I appreciated singing with you on stage over the years. And
thank you.
Did you know we're going on 17 years performing together and knowing each other's
friends? No. It doesn't feel like it.
I know, and so I can sit here and talk to you all day, but I'm afraid that's it, Michelle.
Is that it?
We want to invite you to come see us in person because you are the reason we perform.
Yes, you are. And today and always, be thankful. Count your blessings. Remember that your family and your friends are priceless. And your health is wealth.
Have a wonderful and happy and very safe November.
And until next time, be jazzy.